Dear world, I am pretty sure that you have heard much about Thailand. That's right, Thailand, the land of freedom, the land whose people are proud to say we love our king, and mean every word of what they say, the land that welcomes all religions, and the land whose people are peaceful, yet who are willing to fight for what is right and for what they believe. For the past month or so up until now, we have been experiencing a national turmoil that has drawn worldwide attention. This situation was caused by a political crisis created by our government, the very same government that we, the Thai people, elected to work for the country on behalf of all of its citizens, especially the underprivileged among us. I am not here to state all of the reasons the government ended up in this situation, because I know for a fact that, if you are reading this article, you already know many of them. So even though deep down inside I really want to say more about what has been going on in Thailand, I won't. The purpose of this article is to kindly beg you, the world, to understand us. Please don't look at what has been going on here and conclude that we don't believe in democracy. We most certainly do. We're not revolutionaries. We don't believe in violence. We are a democratic people. Just because we want to postpone the election, that doesn't mean that we are denying democracy. No, we simply want to clean up our house first, so that we can then make it our home sweet home. Right now, our house is so messy, dirty, and not in any condition to comfortably live in. So please, don't think that we are anti-election. We all do want the election to happen, but it has to be at the right time and for the right reasons. We as a people don't believe in dictatorship, not at all. The protesters out there are not stupid, not crazy, and not ignorant. They are out there for good reasons, reasons that their hearts and their minds tell them are right. Please don't misunderstand and misjudge us people who very much love our country by the tumultuous situation we are in right now. If we rush to set up the election for political expediency, we know for a fact that we will run into the same problems again. It will be a vicious cycle of government corruption, possibly with terrorist influence from outside the country, further undermining our educational system. The government has already taken control of the television, radio, and newspaper media, choosing what people can or can't hear or see. More importantly, the government has refused to abide by the verdict of constitutional law. They use money to buy their power in parliament. The government treats our country like a personal business, earning the benefits for themselves. All they can think of is their return on investment. The PM doesn't even have leadership skills. She was selected to be PM because her brother bought it for her. Her brother is out there coaching her to do all the wrong things, which has ended up hurting the country in ways that you probably can't imagine. And, last but not least, this government plans to use the election as a tool for achieving a virtual dictatorship. You may wonder, how so? If they can force the election to happen in the near future, they will, as they did before, grab control of the parliament, and do the same things all over again. Thaksin has so much money, he would buy votes for his sister again. He would buy the politicians, the lawyers, the policemen, the military, etc. They would listen to him and willingly follow his instructions. They would never think about what's best for the country or the people. All they would think about is how they are going to get the money for themselves. Thaksin would use the dirty election to legitimize whatever he wants via his sister or someone else from his family. That's why we say we need to wait. We definitely want to have an election, but it has to be a legitimate election, one that results in a government chosen by the people, for the people, a democratic government that benefits all Thais, not just one family. Of course, there is no guarantee how the election, whenever it is held, will turn out. We don't have a crystal ball to see the future, but we must do our best to prevent the evil cycle from happening again. You may be inclined to believe that the only way to prove that Thailand still believes in democracy is to have the election right away. In most cases, I would agree with you. But just like anything else, there are always exceptions. I believe that the situation in Thailand today is just such an exception. We don't want to sweep the dirt under the carpet only to have it come back and bite us in the ass. We want to permanently get rid of it, and hopefully have a clean house for all of us and for generations to come. Please understand, we don't want to be dictated to. We want to have freedom. We believe in democracy. But we have to take care of the problems first. Please don't ask how are we going to build the new house while the house is on fire. We need to put the fire out first before building the new house. Don't you think it makes sense? Thank you. With all my respect.